Good morning, guys. Welcome to the YouTube channel of the Bitcoin family. My name is Didi Tayutu. Yes, I am the guy that 3 years ago sold everything he owned, all his belongings, inclusive his house, his cars, his company, everything else. And we went all into Bitcoin as a family and started to travel the world. We are still traveling the world now, coming to you guys from Chalaklamb Beach, here between these beautiful squid fishing boats in Chalaklamb, Thailand. Today, guys, I'm going to talk to you about the Bitcoin price. I'm going to show you a short-term chart, a long-term chart. I'm going to show you the difference between the bearish outlook and the bullish outlook at the moment. It's going to be very surprising to see what I'm sharing with you in today's video. I'm also going to show you who's trading when and which moments you should wake up or set your alarm to trade because of the biggest volatility in the market at these times. Taking a dip into this newest development on the Lightning Network, Strike, where you can now interact with Bitcoin without having a wallet, but just by using your debit card or your bank account, taking a dip into it. Talking about the Centario in Argentina, which is now exactly the same value as one Satoshi, another currency that had a huge inflation of more than 50%. And ending the video, guys, with another huge fund accessing this market. They have a fund about $190 million worth of Bitcoin. Nothing compared to the $3.5 billion worth of fund at Grayscale, but still it's a big player. And I'm going to show you how Grayscale diversified their portfolio to which currencies. Enjoy watching today's video, guys. Let's take a jump into my office. Wow. Yes, welcome to my beautiful office in front of my house here in Chalaklamb Beach in Koh Phangan, Thailand. Sorry guys, this video is a little bit later than normally. That is all because yesterday we had a beautiful party at the Rasta home here in Koh Phangan. After a very long period of lockdown, since the 1st of July, all the bars in Thailand are allowed to open again, which made my evening yesterday a very beautiful evening with some drinks and some fun, as you can see in these videos, guys. Was open, everything was fully open, the band was playing, people were dancing, people were singing, people were just celebrating the first official open party again here in Koh Phangan, Thailand. I had a lot of fun with my friend Holger, a German guy also traveling the world with his family, and with all the team of houseofdao.io, of course, also there. Everybody was there just to celebrate. We could finally listen to live music, have fun all together. The Bitcoin price, guys, yes, we are going to look at the long term and the short term. The short term, I'm going to take this chart of Lisa Ann Edwards because she made a very cool tweet today. And I'm very excited to see if this tweet is preparing us for the future, her chart is showing us. If you look at this 4 hour chart, like I said yesterday, you can see the A, B, C, D, E, and then the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 going all the way up to 12K in Bitcoin. This would mean we need a 2K Bitcoin candle in the next couple of days. I don't know if this is possible. Yes, I know we saw already big candles in Bitcoin, like $1,300 US candles in Bitcoin. A 2K candle seems a little bit big for me, but you know, you never know, because she tweeted, and I liked the tweet, that at the 2nd of July, $930 million worth of future contracts in Bitcoin expired. And they have about 72 hours to re-enter the market, because else they will be set free for the rest of the market. So these people get the opportunity now to recontract their futures. That's $930 million worth of futures. So this could lead to a peak in the Bitcoin candle, maybe of 2K. Let's see if Lisa is right. I tend to like Lisa's charts because of the colors, but also because of the outcomes, because many of her charts are just exactly correct if it comes to the price movement. So let's see if this time she is correct as well. Let's see if we can see a 2K candle. If we will see a 2K candle, oh my God, I will be very, very happy, because that means that we are finally moving up from the sideways movements in the last couple of weeks, guys. I'm getting tired of the sideways movement. I want some excitement. I want some action. I want Bitcoin to move up or down, both fine with me. If we go down, we could go down to 8K or 7K. I pick up the Bitcoins there to ride the rest of this beautiful flight into the moon in the next 2 years. If we look at this chart, this chart shows us a possible wick of reaccumulation phase that could lead into a price jump again. This chart is showing us even 14K Bitcoin. If you take a look at these wick of reaccumulation phase and all the options that can happen, you need to look at this image, that one. In this image, you can see that every time we are entering this reaccumulation phase and we enter this wick of spring action, like you can see on the second option in the wick of charts, this spring action always leads up to a jump up, like a V-shape, and then you get this small accumulation phase, and then whoop, we go up. The chart is now showing us an exact copy of this wick of spring action. So let's see if this is going to happen, because then Lisa will be right and this guy will also be right, because then the 12K will not be the end, but then we will go to 14K. What the hell, maybe we even push it all up the way to 16K. If all these price actions happen, guys, people will get excited, people will jump on board. They don't want to miss out on this moon movement, so you know, that will make sure we can go even higher than the 12 or the 14K. The bears, guys, the bears see completely the opposite. They see that this Ichimoku cloud on this chart, this one, do you like these sounds I make with my mouth? Yeah, it's not a special effect in iMovie, it's my own sound. So this chart of the Ichimoku cloud shows us that what happened just before the March dump, we entered the Ichimoku cloud, then we moved sideways in the cloud, where we created this bearish flag, and after this bearish flag in the Ichimoku cloud, we dropped with 50% all the way through the Ichimoku cloud to the bottom, guys. And this move, we are now exactly copying again. We are entering the Ichimoku cloud, we have been going sideways, creating this bearish flag in the Ichimoku cloud, which could lead to another 50% drop, which could bring us all the way back to like 5K, 4.5K. This is if we repeat what happened in the March crash. I don't know, nobody knows. That is, I just want to share with you guys, you have a bullish scenario and you have a bearish scenario. Both scenarios can play out. If you ask me, my personal opinion is that we are going to follow this bullish scenario, because all these bullish indicators I've been educating you guys on in my last couple of videos. Please watch these videos where I talk about all these long-term and short-term indicators that are pretty bullish at the moment. So my personal opinion is that we are going up from here, maybe to the mid 8,000 level, to pick up some more people on strength to break the level of 10,500. But I think we will do this in the next couple of weeks, my opinion. Something really cool as well is that we can see who's trading on what time. If we take this chart shows us the Asian, the European and the New York opening times in the market. If you look at the gray line, this is Asia. The green line, this is Europe. And the red line, this is the New York time opening, guys, of the market. If you look at the chart, you can see these vertical lines going down. The biggest volatility is every time when the New York market opens. If you see these red lines, mostly at the red lines, you see the biggest crash or the biggest run up. This is showing us that every time that New York opens, that New York wakes up, that then the biggest volatility is expected. So that would be the best time to place your trades, because then you can make the biggest moves up or down every time when New York wakes up. To be very clear, this is a 15-minute chart. So because you can see the volatility the best on the 15-minute chart now, this is every time when these markets open on these times on the chart, then you can see the volatility. Really cool. Now you can set your alarm clock to all these times, because every time when these markets open, you see the biggest movement. So set your alarms, set your trading alarms, wake up, put your trades in and go to sleep again, and wake up at the next opening of the market. I don't think that would be a perfect life, because then I think you will be in lack of sleep. The best times to trade, guys, is between 3 p.m. and 4 p.m. UTC time. Universal Time. Between 3 p.m. and 4 p.m., about 6.5 million worth of Bitcoin is being traded. For example, at 9 a.m., only 2 million US dollar of Bitcoin is being traded. So if you want to optimize your trading, you trade between 3 and 4 p.m. UTC time. And the best days to do this, guys, is Wednesdays and Thursdays, because in this graph we can see that these times are the most busy times, the most transactions take place in these times, and these days, Wednesday and Thursday, exactly the middle of the week, these 2 days are the best trading days, because these days show the most volume when it comes to trading Bitcoin. Really cool information again about Bitcoin trading, the times and days you should be trading. Some really big news in the Bitcoin scene now is the new project on the Bitcoin Lightning Network just launched. It is called Strike, and Strike is telling us now that we don't need all the nodes, the wallets and everything anymore to interact with Bitcoin. Strike now created a second layer application that makes it possible to interact with Bitcoin directly from your credit card or your bank account. Okay, one of the founders tweeted, you can now pay your Lightning invoices with your credit card and your bank account now speaks Bitcoin. So this is one of the biggest developments in Bitcoin in the last few months. I don't know what to think about it yet. I still need to dig into the project. I still need to educate me about the project, because I don't see why we as a Bitcoin community now should be happy that our bank accounts speak Bitcoin, because I thought we were disrupting this monetary system and I thought we didn't want to support the banks anymore. So why would we be happy that our bank accounts now speak Bitcoin? Maybe I'm completely wrong. Maybe I need to read more into this project to understand it. I did try to install it this morning. I succeeded in downloading the app. I succeeded in filling in my name and everything. But then I arrived at this point where I need to fill my telephone number, and I could only choose for a United States telephone number, which I sadly don't have. So I couldn't test the app further for you guys. What I could see is that there is a social profile connected to Strike. My social account now is strikeme.dd or something, or strikeme/dd, which is cool. So I already reserved my name in this new Strike app. Now I just need to see how I can do my KYC without having a US telephone number. Let's see how this evolves. Let's see what this does to the market. Yes, I can understand that this will that will simplify the onboarding into Bitcoin and the use of Bitcoin. But still, I think we still need to fight for the goal for peer-to-peer transactions and micropayments by using cryptocurrency in whole without being connected to banks anymore. Because, you know, in my opinion, the goal of Bitcoin should still be to give equal access to everybody in the world to this monetary system. So by using Bitcoin, and if I look at Strike now, guys, I can only see access for those people that or have a debit card, credit card, or a bank account. So what about all the other peoples that still don't have a bank account or a credit card? As far as I can understand now, Strike is not providing a solution for all the unbanked. So let's see how this one evolves. I'm going to dig deeper into it and come back to you about this project in another video. After Lebanon had a huge inflation, Argentina now followed up as well with a 50% inflation. One Centavo is now equal to one Satoshi. Smallest coin in Argentina is now equal to one Satoshi. I read something really cool that probably this coin now, the Centavo, the value of the metal is probably higher than the value of the money worth of this coin. So probably all the Argentina people are now going to take these coins to a crap yard, or how do you call this, and to sell their currencies for the metal worth of this coin. Then they will have more to spend than if they use it to spend it in a store. Crazy things happening on the world now. Which country is going to be the next one? So we had Lebanon, so we had Venezuela, so we had Argentina now. Which one is going to be next? I think the Vietnamese dong is also worth one Satoshi. I don't know for sure. I need to check this. But which country will have the biggest inflation next? So which country will understand the true value of Bitcoin very fast because of all these economical events happening in 2020 and probably also in 2021. Guys, there is another huge fund entering the Bitcoin space. I think it's a $190 million worth of fund. It's the NYDIG fund. This one is now creating a fund of $190 million US dollar worth of Bitcoin. Of course, it's not as big as Grayscale that has like 3.5 billion worth of Bitcoin in the Bitcoin fund. But still, this shows that bigger funds, bigger market players are entering the market and are opening these Bitcoin funds for their customers so that they can also enjoy this beautiful ride into the moon. Because all these big funds, they understand what is going to happen in the next couple of years. That is why they are giving access to their clients to invest in these Bitcoin funds, so they can give these clients a very beautiful return on investment, make them very happy, and tie them to them for the rest of their lives. Because if people make profit through a fund, they will keep trusting the fund till the fund doesn't perform anymore. But if they are going to perform with 4,000%, if Bitcoin is going to go that high, my God, these people will be very happy, and very happy that they invested in these Bitcoin funds at Grayscale or NYDIG, guys. If we look at Grayscale, let's take a look at this chart so we can see what kind of other funds Grayscale has as well. This chart. So you can see on this chart that they are owning 3.5 billion US dollar worth of Bitcoin in the fund. They are owning 5.9 million worth of Bitcoin Cash. They are owning 388 million US dollar worth of Ethereum, 63.5 million dollar worth of Ethereum Classic, $2 million worth of Litecoin, around 400,000 US dollar worth of XLM, Lumen, $2.6 million worth of XRP, I don't like to pronounce XRP, sorry, sorry, and $8.8 million worth of Zcash. So Grayscale doesn't only own $3.5 billion worth of Bitcoin, but they diversified their portfolio in a lot of other cryptocurrencies as well. So take a look at this chart and you can see exactly what cryptocurrencies belong to this Grayscale fund. As promised, guys, a little bit of shorter video, the second shorter video this weekend. Yesterday's video wasn't watched that much time, so maybe I need to keep to the long videos because they get a little bit more watched. Yesterday we were around 3k views. All the other days we were around 4k views. Probably I need to make longer videos, but guys, give me a break as well. In the weekends I like to spend a little bit more time with the kids as well. If you did like today's videos, guys, please give the video a thumbs up, share it in your communities, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell button so you'll be notified of every new video I make, and of course leave a comment, because I love to get feedback and I love to reply to your comments, guys. Today it is Saturday. Yesterday I thought it was already Saturday, but today it's Saturday. I wish you an amazing Saturday and an amazing Sunday, and I hope to see you tomorrow again. And please remember to zoom out in crypto and to zoom in life. Enjoy every single minute of this Saturday, enjoy every single minute of this Sunday, because that is exactly what makes life worth living. See you tomorrow again. Bye. I don't know what happened over here, guys, but all these people here in the island, they celebrate all kinds of cool stuff. I don't know what it is. If somebody knows what this is, what they did celebrate here, they created a circle of flowers with all nature products, shells and all the stuff. It's an art piece on the beach, some candles. They probably celebrated something, maybe the opening of the next half year or something. If you do know what it is, what they were celebrating, just let me know. I'm very curious and interested to know what this means.